Hello everyone, I am Nishant from TKM College of Engineering. Today we will discuss about catastrophic encoders. Catastrophic encoders exhibits a phenomenon called catastrophic error propagation. So for studying the concept of catastrophic error propagation, we will consider a 2-1-2 convolution encoder with G of 1, 110, G of 2, 101. Check whether the given encoder is catastrophic. So I wrote the encoder like this, and this is X of 1 and this is X of 2. So for if we consider all one must message sequence, so that is let M equal to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, etc. So we consider a message sequence of all ones. Now in transform domain approach, X1 of D can be written as M of D into G1 of D. So this will be equal to, what is M of D is 1 plus D square plus etc. into G1 of D is, so we can consider G1 of D equal to 1 plus D, since G of 1 is 110, G1 of D is 1 plus D, and G2 of D equal to 1 plus D square. So M of D into G1 of D is M of D into G1 of D is 1 plus D. So similarly, X2 of D can be written as M of D into G2 of D. So this will be equal to 1 plus D square plus etc. into 1 plus D square. So before proceeding further, we know that 1 by 1 plus x can be written as 1 plus x the whole raised to minus 1, which can be expanded as 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus etc. Similarly, 1 by 1 plus d can be expanded as 1 plus d raised, can be written as 1 plus d raised to minus 1, which can be expanded as 1 plus d square plus etc. Because instead of minus we are using plus, because we are considering only x or addition. So minus and plus are same, so we will write it as 1 plus d square plus etc. gone. So this equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now equation 1 can be written as x1 of d equal to 1 by 1 plus d into 1 plus d, so which is equal to 1, so which implies 1 plus 0 d plus 0 d square plus etc. Now x2 of d can be written as 1 by 1 plus d. Equation number 2 gives x2 d equal to 1 by 1 plus d into 1 plus d square. Okay, so again, since we are considering x or addition, 1 plus d square can be written as 1 plus d square equal to 1 minus d square. Since we are considering x or addition, this can be equal to 1 plus d square, no problem. So this will be equal to 1 plus d into 1 minus d, or this will be equal to 1 plus d into 1 plus d, okay, which is equal to 1 plus d the whole square. Since we can write the expression like this because we are considering only the x or addition. So now this equation number 3 can be written as x2 of d equal to 1 by 1 plus d into 1 plus d the whole square. So cancelling, we will get it as 1 plus d. So this is equation number 4. This is equation number 5. That is, finally we get it as x1 of d equal to 1 plus 0d plus 0d square plus etc. And x2 of d equal to 1 plus d plus 0d square plus etc. Or we can write it as x of 1 equal to 1 0 0 0, x of 2 equal to etc. 1 1 0 0 etc. So now x equal to x is this one. Now x can be written as 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 like this. So even though our input message signal m equal to 1 1 1 1 1, we are considering an all one sequence. Now the coded sequence is 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 like that, it will goes. Now suppose if this code word is transmitted through the channel, and suppose noise specifically affected on these three bits. Now the output from the channel can be written as 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 like this. So even though the message sequence is all one sequence, the coded sequence from the output of the channel will be all zero sequence. So when this all zero sequence are fed to the Viterbi algorithm, it will be decoded as m dash equal to 0 0 0 0 like this. So just compare the input sequence is all one sequence, and output sequence from the at the receiver side is all zero sequence. That means so we can see that finite number of errors in the coded sequence at channel may leads to infinite number of errors at the receiver side. So as we know, this is your message sequence, this is coded sequence at transmitter, and this is your received coded sequence. That is, finite number of errors in the coded sequence in the channel may leads to infinite number of decoding errors at the receiver side. So അതുകൊണ്ട് അതിനൊരു ഒരു ദുരന്തമാണെന്നാണ് നമുക്ക് പറയാൻ പറ്റുന്നത്. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഇതിനെ കറ്റാസ്ട്രോഫിക് എറർ പ്രൊപ്പഗേഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫൈനൈറ്റ് നമ്പർ ഓഫ് എറേഴ്സ് മേ ലീഡ്സ് ടു ഇൻഫിനിറ്റ് നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ഡീകോഡിംഗ് എറേഴ്സ്. നൗ ഹൗ ക്യാൻ വി അവോയ്ഡ് ദിസ് കറ്റാസ്ട്രോഫിക് എറർ പ്രൊപ്പഗേഷൻ? സോ The condition for avoiding catastrophic error propagation is the necessary and sufficient condition for a convolution encoder to avoid catastrophic error propagation is GCD of the generated polynomial, that is G1 of D, G2 of D, etc., GN of D should be equal to 1. So in this case, so in the given example, so this is our example convolution encoder. So we have only two generated polynomials, namely G1 of D and G2 of D. Now we need to check whether the given convolution encoder is a catastrophic encoder or not. So before going to check whether the given convolution encoder is catastrophic, we need to find the GCD of two numbers using extended Euclidean algorithm. Euclidean algorithm. Hoping you may know this algorithm. So we will try to find the GCD of 63 and 27. So in extended Euclidean algorithm, what we will do is, so you write 63, 27 here. So here we will write it as remainder. Here quotient. So now write 1001. Now write your numbers here, 63 27. Now divide 63 by 27. Now the quotient is 2 and remainder will be 9. Now you should complete these entries here. Now the entry at this point will be equal to 1 minus 0 into 2, that is 1. Here is 0 minus 1 into 2, that is minus 2, that is 1 minus 0 into 2, that is 1. And next is 0 minus 1 into 2, that is equal to minus 2. Okay, now again we will divide 27 by 9. Now the remainder will be 0 and the quotient will be 3. Now how will you complete this entries? This entry will be 0 minus 1 into 3, that is equal to minus 3. Here minus 3. And this entry will be 1 minus of minus 2 into 3. 1 minus of minus 2 into 3. This is equal to 7. So now we can write minus 3 or so 0 equal to minus 3 into 63 plus 7 into 27. So what does this indicate? This indicates that 63 and 27 has common divisors. So if GCD of two numbers is 1, that indicates that there won't be any common divisors between these two numbers. Now we will use the concept of extended Euclidean algorithm for checking whether the given convolution encoder is catastrophic or not. So let g1 of d equal to, or like we can write it as g of 1 equal to 111. So with this encoder we already discussed, and g of 2 equal to 101. So correspondingly we have g1 of d equal to 1 plus d square, and g2 of d equal to 1 plus d square. Now we will check whether the given convolution encoder that we already discussed in the previous classes is catastrophic or not. So by using extended Euclidean algorithm we need to check whether GCD of 1 plus d square 1 plus d square is it is 1 or not. Check whether this is 1 or not. Okay, so we will write the polynomial like this, d square plus d plus 1 d square plus 1. So here is remainder, here is quotient. So first step is write your polynomials here, d square plus d plus 1 d square plus 1, 1 0 0 1. Okay, now we divide d square plus d plus 1 by d square plus 1, that is d square plus d plus 1 is divided by d square plus 1. So 1 d square plus 1, we will get it as d. So the remainder is d, quotient is 1. Now we need to fill these entries. This entry will be 1 minus 0 into 1. This is equal to 1. And this entry will be 0 minus 1 into 1. This is equal to minus 1, but we are considering only x or addition. There is no minus. So again, this is 1. Okay, now next step is divide d square plus 1 by d. D square plus 1 is divided by d. So we have d square. So this is remainder is 1. Now the remainder is 1, quotient is d. Now we need to fill these entries. This entry is 0 minus 1 into d. This is d minus d, which is equal to d. D. Now this entry will be 1 minus 1 into d. This is equal to 1 minus d, which is equal to 1 plus d, because there is no minus in our case. So this is 1 plus d. Okay, so we can write it as 1 equal to d into d square plus d plus 1 plus 1 plus d into d square plus 1. So anyway, we got the remainder as 1. So this is not a catastrophic encoder. So that means by using this particular encoder, there won't be any catastrophic error propagation present, because our condition is the GCD of this generator polynomial should be 1. So we got the remainder as 1, the GCD of these two numbers as 1. So there is no problem. So now we will consider our previous example as this is d square plus 1. So we need to check whether GCD of d square plus 1 and d plus 1. So if it is anything other than 1, that indicates that it is catastrophic. Okay, we will check. So we have d square plus 1, d plus 1. This is remainder. This is quotient. We will write this polynomial here, d square plus 1, d plus 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Now what is this entry? So divide d square plus 1 by d square plus 1 by d plus 1. We have d, so this is d square plus d, we have 1 plus d. So the remainder is again 1 plus d, quotient is d. Now this entry will be what? This entry is 1 minus 0 into d, which is 1, and this entry is 0 minus 1 into d, which is equal to minus d, equal to d. Now we will divide these two polynomials, that is d plus 1 is divided by 1 plus d, which is the remainder will be 0, and the quotient will be d. Quotient will be 1. Now this entry will be 0 minus 1, 1. This entry will be 1 minus d, that is 1 plus d. Okay, anyway, we can see the GCD of these two numbers is 0. Since the GCD of d square plus 1 and d plus 1 equal to 0, which implies that this is catastrophic.